In this video, we'll be working on back bends using the chair. I have a few videos I posted on back bends, one in Salabhasana, where you really learn the basics on tucking and removing that compression in the lower back while practicing back bends. So I would definitely recommend starting there and warming up to come into the chair for your back bend practice. But here we go, we're gonna use a chair, a belt, and some blocks to improve and progress in our back bend practice. So here we go. So I want to come up to the chair, and it's nice in the beginning to use a little bit of padding. So I like these little cut up mats. You can definitely pad, especially this part here where we're gonna lay back with our chest here. If you have a neck that sometimes is still a little bit weak or there's pain in the neck, be very careful during this practice. And I would recommend using a bolster or a block to support the head while it's hanging here on the chair. So just have that handy in case you need it. And just a block to support the head so that it's not dangling, I guess, would be a great thing to do. Okay, so here we go. So let's get on our chair. So we'll come in, carefully come into the chair, one leg at a time. And I'm going to come into the chair and lay back on the chair. So this seat of the chair will be around my chest line, my mid chest line here on the back. So I can keep my legs bent and come down and see how that feels. So if I feel like I need a support for my head, I use that. If not, I work here and I strengthen the neck and the ability to be here in this upside down position. So I start slow and I notice how my my back untucks, right? It creates this exaggerated back bend here. So I want to work on that a little bit and tuck the pelvis here, remove that extra back bend. So I tuck the pelvis. So I can work here a little bit. If I need to come up, I'll show you how to get up. You leave the chin facing up. So don't bring the chin to the chest to come up, meaning don't lead with the chin to come up. Lead with this upper part of the clavicle here. So I place my elbows on the chair, hold on to the side, and I lead with this. And I slowly bring the chin down. So that's very important to maintain the health of your neck in these poses. Okay, so let's go a little bit further. So once you're comfortable laying down, putting the head back, if you need a support, you know how to grab it and put it there or have the bolster waiting for you, then you can start progressing. Okay, let's do this. So we'll come down. Come down here, and I'm going to extend my legs to the wall here. So I have this a little bit more challenging, and I'm opening the chest, I'm lifting the chest, opening the chest, tucking the pelvis, rolling my thighs into one another. And I can use a belt here. You know, I can tie a belt here and hold the belt. If my hands reach, I can grab onto the side of the legs. A better way to do it would be to turn the arms externally. Then I get a very good opening here in the chest. So rotate the hands and bring the chest, tuck the pelvis. Okay, great. So now we're gonna come up. And we're gonna work on the legs. So grab your belt, I'm going to leave this one here for now, and then grab a freestanding belt, and very carefully checking in with your lower back, bring the left leg up, and hang it here, and this may be enough, so take it easy bringing the leg up. So have the leg hang in the chair like this for a second, take a few breaths here, and we're going to go back down. So I can bring the belt around my foot here, hold on to it. Okay, come down. And so without holding your breath, come down. So inhale, exhale, come down. Then extend your lower leg and tuck the pelvis, lift the chest, breathe here, soften the eyes, the ears, the throat, and then you can grab the belt and extend the leg. So press the right leg into the wall, make the bottom leg very firm and active, tuck the pelvis, and then straighten this knee. Make sure the lifted leg has a very, very straight knee. Grab your lifted heel and point it to the wall. Stretch it as if you want it to go all the way up and hit the ceiling. So really straight. And then if you can release any tension in the groin, bring the leg down in that space created by releasing the tension. Okay. And then slowly bring the leg down and come up. Remembering to keep the chin up. Then you will do your second side. So bring the leg down, do your second side. And then you can be finished here if you want. So carefully come out of the chair, or we can do a final stretch here. So you have to come out very carefully, come to the edge of your chair here, and you're gonna bring your knee down and the second knee down. And so you're essentially almost in a Urdhva Dhanurasana or camel pose, but in this one you're going to move forward a little bit, and you can pad this back seat with a bolster if you can't come all the way down, so that you have a height here, a big pillow, or you can come down and lay down on the chair. And then bring the hands back. Yeah. Press the feet, the top of the feet, press the top of the feet onto the ground. Tuck the pelvis, open the chest. And then same thing, pull yourself up. And to come out of this one, you just bring the chair down here. And then you can use this as a way to twist. And then you can twist to the left. So lift the chest, twist. Make sure that the opposite, so if you're twisting to the left here, make sure that the right side hip is not untucking, it's not creating a back bend. So you can use this as a twist. Then come to the center and then slowly out. Okay. All right, and that is a little sequence that you can use to work on your back bends. Take it slowly. It improves very well over time, especially if you do it step by step. If you have any questions, ask a teacher to take a look and see how you're doing. There might be some modifications, some different padding or rolled up mats and things that you can put underneath your sacrum and your body if there's a lot of pain there. And then it's a really great way to progress in back bends, and it's also very fun. So I hope you enjoyed it. If you haven't already, please subscribe and like and share if you felt this video was good. Okay, thank you very much.